Gotcha! Sora and Riku continued traveling from dream to dream. However, the cloaked boy, Ansem, and Xemnas appeared everywhere Sora and Riku went, misleading them with every encounter. Meanwhile, Mickey was caught up in one of Maleficent's schemes, but he was saved by Lee, formerly known as Axel, from Organization 13. Master Yen Sid agreed to make Lee a Keyblade wielder to catch Xehanort off guard in hopes of defeating him. Master Xehanort's plan was revealed at last. Terra, Aqua, and Ventus entered into a grueling final battle. As they fought, Xehanort summoned Kingdom Hearts. Terra's body became a vessel for Xehanort, but his lingering will and devotion to Aqua and Ventus remained attached to his armor. Even knowing that his own heart would be destroyed in the process, Ventus fought to stop the Keyblade from forming. As Ventus struggled, Aqua confronted Vanitas, who had taken control of Ventus's body. Drawing strength from her friends, she destroyed the Keyblade. Ventus's heart fell into a deep sleep. Aqua faced off against Terra, whose body was controlled by Master Xehanort. To restore his heart to him, Aqua fought with all she had. Xehanort drove Terra's heart out of his body. Terra fell to darkness. Refusing to lose her friend, Aqua sent him back to the Realm of Light. But he awoke with no memories and called himself Xehanort. Trapped in the realm of darkness and all alone, Aqua was about to give up the endless battle with darkness when her connections to her friends appeared in the form of a brilliant light and saved her. Sora, still just a child, had previously joined his heart with Ventus's. The connection they shared brought Ventus's wounded heart back to him.
Thank you. Yeah.